Oh my gosh, I was muted. I was muted from the panel. Is it okay now? Okay, we hear you now. Okay, so the problem was that I was muted because I had to muted because of yesterday's convention. Yeah, I'm really sorry. So let's start it over again. Thanks for the follow. I feel so dumb. I feel so dumb. Thanks for the follow, Chiaki. And yes, I'm streaming this late because yesterday I had my panel at a convention, right? And I was so scared and so stressed, and all the adrenaline in my system kept me up until like 4 a.m. in the morning. I know that's lame, but that's the truth. I couldn't fall asleep until 4 a.m. So I slept like 4 hours, and then in the morning I went visited some of my relatives. We were hanging out outside, and I have really really bad pollen allergies. So when I came back home, I fell asleep for 3 or 4 hours. So I'm really really fucked up today with my sleep schedule. You know, relatable, honestly. So I've decided to stream this late at night because that convention made me focus on Polish speaking content this week, and it's my first week when I'm streaming on Twitch, and I didn't want to make the Twitch audience feel abandoned, you know? When I overthink, I can't sleep either. Oh yeah, that's the point. Well, just it's not the melatonin that I need. It's just the overthinking, and the fact that a panel was a new experience for me. Cause when you are hosting a panel, it's more interactive. The participants, they can talk to you, so it's different than streaming in a sense that when you are streaming, you are in total control over everything, and when you are hosting a panel, people can say whatever they like, really, and that's really really stressing me out because I'm not really a people's person. Maybe some melanin instead. Maybe I would if I get a tan. That would be nice. So I hydrate. Yes, but all in all, firstly, sorry for being muted. In the beginning, I feel so dumb. I feel like such a dum-dum now. But sorry for being muted. And yeah, let's go. Let's continue with this illustration. So I made some changes ever since the last stream because the original illustration for Romeo and Cinderella has this really, really weirdly positioned hand. And I have to make sure there is no picture of me in the layers. Okay, I removed it. Okay, that's good. Because I literally, I have this really, really big mirror in my wardrobe. So I positioned myself on a pillow on the ground. I twisted my body to figure out oh, you can see how to position the body in this illustration. So I drew it like this because I honestly like it more. The hand looks better without that lanky ass hand. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the hand, even in the original drawing. It's really, 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 really awkward. Lanky looking ass hovering above you. Yeah, you know, I think the idea that the original illustrator had was to introduce some strong masculine energy to the picture, but I think it didn't work as well as they may have thought it will. It's just don't get me wrong, it is an flat pillow. It is an iconic illustration. But it's just not the best choice. Not the best choice for an illustration. send nudes. Oh my gosh, that escalated so quickly. Oh, no, no multiplying. I want it to be normal. Also, speaking of the convention, it went really, really well, and I was so well prepared. But in the end of the day, I ended up just hanging out with the chat most of the time. I didn't even make all the points that I wanted to make, because they were like, oh, boobies, a female, like they've never seen one. That's why my mods told me what happened. They told me I shouldn't like overstress. I shouldn't over prepare, and I definitely did over prepare. But that's what makes me feel confident. You know, when I'm really really well prepared for presentation for school and stuff like that. So you can imagine how hard it is to me to just kick back and relax. A female girl? Yeah, a female girl, right? What a rare specimen. Such a rarity, truly. Oh my gosh. Oh, just here. Yeah. This is the place. So I drink my water. After all presentation, we gathered some people and been doing Cards Against Humanity Convent Edition. Oh, that's so neat. That's so neat. But like, I had such a bad introvert burnout. I think that's one of the things that were keeping me up at night. It also gave me a first-hand convention experience, because every time I go to the convention, I end up just pulling all-nighters, not sleeping at night, and then being tired. Flatress. What's a flatress? I wanted to type mattress, but I made a typo. Yeah. Okay, I need more drinks. One of Trump cards was White Nishi. Ay. Must have been a nice game. I kind of wish I stayed behind to say that, but then again, like I'm not very social. That's something I really really want to work on, because I don't want to seem like I'm like I'm distant, especially towards my audience and those fellow creators that might want to collab with me. I don't want to seem like I'm cold and distant. It's just the fact that I am so shy. I'm just so shy and so bad with people overall. It's just so tiring for me to interact with people. So it is something that I struggle with a lot. And I don't want people to think that I'm looking down on them or that I'm being condescending. I'm just so afraid. I'm so afraid of everyone, everyone in the community, really, which is not a good thing for a VTuber, because the better your connections, the more exposure you get, right? Oh well, that is definitely something that I want to work on in the future, you know. for now, I just want to focus some more on developing my illustration skills, singing some more, editing more videos. But we have to wait and see what. How the situation with my work and my family life progresses. Whoa! Oh, send me. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for gifting a sub to Blended. Oh my gosh. Thank you. Thank you so much. Also, it means the world to me that you gave the sub to Blended, because even on yesterday's panel, I told everybody that Blended is literally the first person who has believed in me as a creator. And if it wasn't for Blended, I would have stopped posting. And that's a fact. So thank you so much. Thank you so much for gifting it to Blended. I'm genuinely very, very happy about it, because in the end of the day, when you are a small creator, just the smallest interaction with your audience keeps you going, right? And when people send you money, or when they subscribe to you, when they become members, it reassures you that the way of creation, that your way of being content creator, the way you've chosen is good, and people enjoy the content you're making. So yeah. Thank you so much. Blended MVP. Yeah, like I have no idea how Blended found me, but I'm so glad he did. I'm so glad he did, because it allowed me to grow so much, not only as a VTuber, but also as a person. So I will be forever grateful for Blended and to Blended. Forever grateful. Oh my, I'm getting a bit emotional. This is just like for a small streamer like me, this is such a big deal. You guys really, 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 really make my day. So I'm genuinely, truly, truly, truly happy. Complete coincidence. YouTube gods have decided to let me give you a chance, I guess. Oh my gosh. What did he tell me? It wasn't anything particular that he said. It was just the fact that Blended was there, like in the comment section. One of the first positive things that I've heard about my content, that were from Blended, because before. Because before Blended, in the beginning, it was just comments like, "Oh my gosh, what a cringe, kill yourself, just edgy 14-year-old comments, stuff like that." And then yeah, just some positivity. So in the end of the day, even if you get 10 negative comments and there's one really, really positive, it really, really, really gives you hope that you can improve. And if you try your best, you can actually start putting out good content, you know? So that's great. That was really, really, really neat, really nice. I was thinking you said to her something funny and kept her going. No, it wasn't like that. It was just the fact that I saw a person pop up on the channel and then go back to the channel regularly, you know? So that was nice. That was nice to have somebody like that to have a regular. That's probably because Blended and I, we both have this wacky sense of humor. But yeah, that was constructive criticism and encouragement, because There are some people that give you criticism, that sends you hate, and they disguise it as criticism. And then there are people who genuinely tell you what needs to be improved, where the problematic part is, and which part should be improved on. And that's the part, that's the type of criticism that Blended gave me. Most channels I express my criticism have banned on me. It was never rude, and it was never coming from a place of hatred, because I've gotten comments in the past. Sorry, I need to hydrate. I've gotten comments in the past which were obviously hate comments disguised as criticism, like stuff like, oh, you should, like, your rig is shit, your content is shit, you should just stop uploading, and that would be the best thing you can do to improve your content, stuff like that. And then Blended was like, oh, maybe if you did the audio better here, or just small things that build up to an overall improvement as a creator. So that was so nice to have him. Well, I maybe a little bit remember that I'm still new here. I can imagine Blended not funny. Yeah, I think that honestly Blended is such a great part of my content at this point. We are a packaged deal, you know, Blended and I. Blended and I, a package deal. And now I'm thinking how to shade it. Maybe a simple shade. Shell shade? Cell shade. A simple cell shade. And then we will call it a day. Shell shade. Cell shade. Oh, that's the kimono. Okay. Maybe we will try to paint it on. If I hate it, I can always plain and simply remove it. Double background music, yeah, bear. What about now? Is it okay now? I have way too many VTubing channels to watch right now. I can't keep up with all of them. Oh yeah, that's definitely a problem. That's definitely a problem. The oversaturation on the market, and there is so many great creators right there. So it's good now, Gucci Gang. Yeah, because the problem is that I only have one audio output. So if I'm listening to my own voice and the music, it kind of doubles it. So yeah, okay. Okay, no music for me. I'm just gonna go dead silent. Just listening to my computer going brrrr. As I try to draw in high resolution, you know? But yeah, as I was saying, the problem nowadays is that there is so many great streamers, which is a blessing and a curse. Johnny have a music stream right now, but I guess I'm gonna stay here. It's honestly okay. You can just switch in between the tabs if you want. I think you can lurk up in three channels or something, and Twitch will count the watch time up to three channels, I think. Not really sure how Twitch works still, which is something that would annoy me if a different creator said it, because I feel like you should investigate the platform that you want to join before you join it. But yeah, all those statistics, I'm not really sure how they work. Yeah, but I watch him because he sings, and I can't really listen to him and talk with you at the same time. Oh yeah, that really is a problem. I'm really, really happy to have you here. but yeah, you can lurk. You can feel free to lurk. Oh, hi Drag, nice to see you here. My keyboard is dying. My W and D are not working like they should. Oh my gosh, Senmia, I feel so sorry for your D not working. Badumts. No, that's probably because you were gaming too much on it now, weren't you? Do you have a mechanical keyboard? I find that switching to the mechanical keyboard has fixed the problems like that for me. Ay. My D is not working. Oh no. Or just clean it. It usually helps. Like, if I have issues with my mechanical keyboard, I just call Nishi. So I dead ass recommend, if you guys have a problem with your mechanical keyboards, just go to my Discord, ask Nishi about it. Because he always preaches how good mechanical keyboards are. Okay, we will try to paint, I guess. I'm still trying to find a good brush for painting, because if you find like one of these brushes that really fake the texture of painting really well. Sorry, I'm rather raspy. If you find a brush that fakes painted on effect really well. Okay, this one is half decent, I think. You can achieve really nice texture of fabric and stuff like that. Clean my D, yes, please, every day. Yes, please, clean your D every single day, please. Cleaning contact pads does work wonders, so give it a try. Oh yeah, people nowadays, they tend to throw away stuff instead of like trying to fix it themselves. As Slavic people, we are crazy about, not crazy about, because that's more of a necessity, just fixing your shit, right? So Slavic people are always really, really good at fixing stuff, because most people cannot afford a new one. Clean your D with rub and alcohol. Oh, 0 out of 10, do not recommend. I remember I was talking once about the mint shower gel from the brand Original Source. You can still see Original Source in the drugstores and in supermarkets, but they removed the mint shower gel. Because that shower gel, it was supposed to be cooling, right? So you were supposed to use it after workouts or during the shower. But they added way too much mint oil to it. So once it came to the contact with the fleshy part of your private parts, it was burning like a bitch. So even now, if you go to the Amazon page of that shower gel, you will read the horror stories. I had such for some time. What, the rubbing alcohol for your D? Oh my gosh. Yabba. You can just use stuff like Octanisept for wounds. Please don't ping me on YouTube or anything like that when I'm streaming on Twitch. On Twitch. Okay, I'm just gonna try painting these folds. I still have no idea what I'm doing. I've been drawing for quite some time lately, but I'm still trying to make stuff up as I go. The advantage of working digital is that you can always fix your mistakes. So that's why I'm so anxious whenever I even doodle in traditional, because you make one mistake, it's final, it never forgives you. But yeah, let's see how it looks. We change to multiply, we kick it down. Yeah, okay, I think we can make it work. 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 Okay, enough internet for the weekend. It's dangerous. What if you go out on a date with your girl and she... What? I meant mint shower gel. Oh my gosh. Oh. What? Oh, okay. It's a YouTube sub. Okay, it's a YouTube sub. The pink subs are for YouTube and then the purple ones are for Twitch. Okay. Calm down. I mean, I think that's how I did it, because I honestly don't remember at this point, but I think I set the purple alerts for Twitch and then the pink ones for YouTube. The problem is that I have them both on, so yeah, we will see them both Saturday night. Yeah. I, as I said before, many times, I wish I could stream at a normal time, but it's just impossible for me. It's just impossible. Like my schedule is so crazy, so hectic. So I just have to work with whatever I have. 2 more minutes of Saturday. Yay! It's Sunday tomorrow. It's almost today. Screw that, I would only stream at times like this. Oh, definitely the advantage of streaming late at night is that nobody needs the kitchen, right? So I can just hang out here with you guys. Not give a fuck, just do whatever I want, and I won't be interrupted, so that's really neat. Okay, wait, the hand, I think it will be like here. Dim, just like freehanding it, and then we will take the finger tool and just try to smudge it a bit. We will see how that looks. If we hate it, we will do it over and over and over again. No stress, no worries. They should be I feel they should be going like towards one spot, those creases. That's how I see other people do it, and that's how I see other people do their fabric studies and stuff. So I'm just trying to fake that kinda in this picture. We will see how it turns out for us. If we don't like it, it is okay. Yubi. I'll be right back. No worries, send me. Yubi. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna reposition myself in my chair. I'm just gonna reposition myself and then yeah, we will continue. That's a very baggy arm sleeve, almost as much as a man's pocket. Yeah, because I started drawing from this picture, right? And you can see that the lady is wearing a full-on kimono in it. So she has those sleeves like this. and they are rather rather baggy, you know. And now we take this fingertip tool and try to make it more blended. try to work it just a bit more. It's actually something that not a single traditional art teacher recommends when you're working traditionally. They say you should never. Oh, I messed it up. They say that you should never use your fingers because they are usually pretty oily. Like your fingers, they have your natural oils, your natural grease. So when you try to smudge something, for example, charcoal with it, it just stains it with grease. So it's actually recommended to use brushes or paper stamps when you're trying to do traditional. But most people still use their fingers, and their stuff looks just fine. So. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do, right. Also, didn't baggy sleeves on girls' kimono meant that she was pure? I'm not sure, because I think it's just a fashion choice. I think like the bigger the sleeves, the higher your position in the society was, because you were able to afford those gigantic slabs of fabric, and like you didn't have to work physically, so you could just have those hang, because like even in the Edo period you could see wagashi wearing kimonos like that, just basically women's kimonos with baggy ass sleeves, and wagashi, they were like male escorts. So I just think that was a thing of a status. Then again, in the history of Japan was so long, so maybe it did mean something else. But I think the bigger sleeves were just a sign of status, nothing else, right? Because if you could afford to have a piece of silk or a piece of fabric that was purely decorative and nothing else, yeah, that meant you're rich. In ancient times, purple dye used to be like very expensive, right? It's why Roman royalty only wore purple. Well, some royalty in Rome even denied their wives purple clothing because it was too expensive. But yeah, it was really, really expensive because they made it from those tiny things found in the sea, right? Blue dye or yellow was much cheaper. Red was made from bugs. That's why the national colors of Poland are red. It's because we had those cities that were called Grody Czerwieńskie, and they were making the red dye over there. That's why all the flags and stuff were red, so that the king could flex on other people that they can afford it, you know, they can afford to manufacture that many red flags. And in the end of the day, being a king of Poland turned out to be the biggest red flag now, didn't it? Okay, let's go with a soft eraser and make it like not very dense. And just blend these in. Do I like it? I'm not entirely convinced. But I think we need to wait and see how it looks in the end before I start complaining about it, or before or before I even erase everything completely. Hey Shima, posture check and stretch time. Oh, okay, sorry, I didn't notice. Okay, I'm gonna have some water and then stretch. Hey Shima, posture check and stretch time. Just imagine why in medieval Renaissance art only water in blue was mostly Mother Mary. Oh yeah, the paint was really expensive because it was made from this mineral called lapis lazuli. So they did save it for Virgin Mary because the paint was really expensive, but the blue dye for fabric could be made from indigo, so that was quite cheap. But if it was made from minerals to achieve this beautiful deep blue they were in church sometimes and stuff like that, then it was expensive. It was white if it was made from lapis lazuli. More stretches. Okay, let's continue. Oh, I think I messed it up. It's because it's a different layer. Yeah. Okay, I should be over here. Just working my folds. Just working my folds. I'm not sure if I am a fan of this line work that I did here, so I will probably end up removing it. We shall see. Now onto this part. Dim. Just a quick wiki check confirms that indigo dyed clothes were a luxury. Okay, because like nowadays it is so cheap. Thanks for the hydrate. Shima learns to manipulate her limbs for the most optimal drumming experience. Colorized. Okay, thanks for the hydrate. I need to check if it is possible to actually make alert sounds for the Twitch redeems, because I tend to overlook those. Okay. I'm not even sure if this part should be in shade. I think I will end up not liking what I've painted that much, but for now let's just keep going and like hope for the best. This is a leg right here. Just mm-hmm. Guess what? You can make an offline hype train on Twitch. Oh, I dead ass have no idea what that is. What's a hype train? I'm not that much into trains, but okay. I will educate myself. I will educate myself about it. Whoa! Choo-choo! Okay, we got the train, and now where is the hype? What's the hype? What's the hype part? Okay, let me take a note. Hype train on Twitch. What is that? Google that later. Choo-choo. Was it me? When people serve and send bits, they start a hype train. During the time, you can earn exclusive emotes. Oh, okay. Turns out streamer can be offline to start and level it. Oh, okay, that's cool. I didn't know that. I should definitely start it then. It's like, you know, send me. I'm not really. Because I've been a VTuber for a really, really long time, and I've seen that if your success in the community wasn't instant, so for example, if you didn't like become partnered on Twitch right away, or if you didn't like get associated with big names, you tend to be stuck as a small channel forever. On one hand, I am working really, really hard and try to do my best to get myself out there, but I've been doing it for so long with results which are not the best, so I'm just trying to be realistic about my goals. I just don't, they say that there is an audience for everyone, but I'm not really sure if I am a person that can succeed. We have to wait and see. Like in the end of the day, even if I stream with just a bunch of people in chat until I retire, because I will have to go to a third job. It's okay. What you need is a raid from few people to get more followers. This helps a lot. Sure, let's see what kind of clothes you have in there. Oh my gosh, you guys. Yeah, you know, just the problem is I haven't been that active on Twitch lately. This is my second stream on Twitch this week, or a third maybe. I think it's a second stream on Twitch. Not really sure. You know what? Let me check really quickly. Let's go. Okay. how do you check it actually? Yeah, it is a third one. So, got you. I don't third, I think. Yeah, so you know, this is still a novelty. And like the problem is that I don't have that many friends, right? Taika streams in Polish on Twitch. Also, we never stream at the same time. So even if she wanted to send me her viewers, I don't think it will work that well on Twitch. So maybe I should network some more. And then we will see how that goes. I just I just want to be able to fulfill my dreams of being a creator. I want to put out more content, but I also have to put food on the table for my family, and I also have to work. So yeah, I've decided I'm not gonna be. I shouldn't be complaining or turning the mood into like more serious one onto these streams, because people come here to relax, not worry about the well-being of a streamer, you know. But yeah, in the end of the day, it is what it is, right? Right. Okay, let's have some water. The chat. Okay, it is actually midnight. Maybe we should put in some highlights in here. I don't even know why I started with the fabric. I usually do that in the end. I usually do that towards the end because I like to have the face done first, to kind of know what kind of a mood will be set for the whole piece. But it's good to switch up your routine here and there, just to see how you can achieve different results even with the skill level you have. Okay, nicer. I do kinda actually dig it. just a bit. I think it turned out kinda nice. Yeah, so this dark, this part should be dark too. Dark. Oh yeah, and then we will stretch the paint from here. I hope I am on the correct layer. Yeah, it is a good layer. Okay, stretch it some. Yeah, I'm actually thinking this could be a bad idea to stream at night, because I'm feeling kind of tired. But it's not sleepiness. Sorry, it's just an overall tiredness from the allergies and just an introvert burnout from the convention, and the family stuff that I was engaged in, but it's okay. I actually find streaming to be quite relaxing too. So yeah, we will just make it a bit less opaque, because that's too harsh of a shadow, I think. Okay, a note for me: do some fabric studies. Definitely do some fabric studies in acrylic paint at home. Those highlights make me afraid that you're gonna turn yourself into Sadako from The Ring or some shit. What highlights? Huh? Yeah. Okay, so maybe I should go back to the face and just try to work on the face a bit. Okay, this is for the irises. Same brush, same brush. So a deeper purplish color. And I'm gonna try to follow the direction of the lashes. Multiply. What the? No, wrong layer. Oh no, oh no. That's the worst. This one, that's this one. Okay. Oh no, 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 not in green. So yeah, following the overall direction of the eyelashes. Maybe like this. Wait, are those not highlights? What were you doing just now? She said it was supposed to be cell shading. Well, like kind of like cell shading, but not really, because with cell shading you are trying to basically shade like you would in animation, right? And I'm basically trying to fake cell shading with the brush, because for cell shading you would normally use like a G pen or something. Oh my gosh, Bandit, that was quick. That was quick. So I'm just trying to do cell shading with more of a brushy brush and just see how it looks. I'm worried that I did this drawing. That my drawing style overall might be too simplistic to try and make those fabric a bit more realistic. So we will see how it looks in the end when I'm done with it. In the end of the day, if I don't like it, it's okay. I will just move on from this drawing to another, and then hopefully use this as a learning process, you know? Okay. So let's shade the skin, multi-skin. Because if we have the cell shade on the skin, we will know exactly where the light source is, right? Click noise. Paczko ma speedrun na stronie. Oh my gosh, there was this meme that they were going to tax them like regular buildings, so in the end of the day they could put toilets in there, so you will be allowed to shit in them. So yeah, that's a cool and funny fact with me. Midnight facts with Shima. Ay. Brushy brush. And this whole ear would be in shade, I think. I don't know, maybe it would be, maybe it wouldn't. I'm just going brushy brush. Oh my gosh. no mustache. No mustache. This is not for you, lady. Am I doing it on a... Yeah, but I did it on the wrong layer again. I knew I was having too much fun with it. I was on the wrong layer. Okay, so... Oh shit, here we go again. Okay, I'm sorry, I cannot resist just drawing on the mustaches. I just cannot resist it. Add it on a secret layer. Yesterday, con attendants were wondering what is stopping them from shitting into magical mud. What is stopping them? I think, firstly, it's the human decency. And secondly, it's the fact that you are, when you want to open it, you have to give them your full data, right? Your first name, last name. Like when you want to send the package. So if you chat into it, they would know, right? They would know. But somehow it doesn't shock me that was something that was discussed at a convention. yeah, anime conventions, they are really something else now, aren't they? Shima with mustache. Fukushima with Momoshevsky. Binda seen it. yeah, the Paczkomat meme. The ultimate Polish dilemma, whether or not to shit into the postal machine. I also think that these are something that's really, really specific to Poland, because I think that the only postal service that's worse than Polish is the one they have in the United States. Or maybe it is just as bad. I had my friend send me some makeup supplies from the States, and the Polish and American post were just sending the packet back and forth like 6 or 7 times from Poland to Texas and back before they finally figured out how to deliver it. And like every time it would return to her home, she would be so pissed, because every time they returned it, she had to go back. So I was so relieved when it finally arrived on my doorstep 1 million years later. We were wondering if the makeup would expire at that point, but it was fine. Oh my god, I said our. Oh no. Plug a horse to our butt and blow away. Oh my gosh, you guys share a butt now. That's interesting. That's something I really want to know more. Let's further investigate the butt that you guys are sharing. Is this the butt of a third party, or does it belong to one of you guys? I'm so curious. So curious about it. I have a story about shit. Wanna hear it? Yeah, okay. You know what? At this point, this VOD is not going. It's not going to YouTube, because we were talking about shit so much. that I think it might actually harm my... it might actually harm the monetization of my YouTube channel. So yeah, go ahead. Just talk about shit. Give zero shits. Basically. So yeah, share your shitty story with us, please. From now on, Jester and I share a body. Oh my gosh, that would be, imagine how funny it would be if you guys were conjoined twins. So in Polish, Siamese twins, right? And you were just chatting with me from two separate computers. Okay, Senmi has a story. So I had a pretty shit day at work yesterday. People pissed me off to the point I was about to leave and go home. So I went to the restroom and to cool myself. After washing my face, I went to the urinal and there was a shit inside. Someone took a shit in the urinal. Oh my gosh. And it's not even the best part. I called the cleaning lady to take care of it, and by the time she arrived, someone came and stuck matches in it. Someone made a hedgehog out of the shit in the urinal. Oh my gosh. Who wrote it? Who wrote this? I refuse to believe that this has happened. Somebody has turned it into a hedgehog now. It's copied from the Discord I wrote. So it can be oppressed, but should be passed. What we've even read? That's such a lovely story. But yeah, I did hear. I did go to an all girls high school, but I remember in middle school, I remember boys were telling that there was always some fucking douchebag that would shit into the urinal, and I was like, why? In present time, because it was a month ago. Jesus Christ! Like I remember when I worked in a thrift store straight out of high school. I think I was like 19, right? And I was like 19, and I was the youngest employee there. And there was one occasion when somebody took a gigantic shit in the dressing room. They literally took a gigantic shit in there, and like they took that shit and they booked it from the store. So at first we were like, did they steal something, right? And then like one of the girls was walking past the dressing room and she smelled something funny. She opened it and there was this huge shit on the floor in the middle of the dressing room, and we were like, oh my gosh, we're not getting paid enough for cleaning that, right? So Jesus freaking Christ, we just took a whole bottle of bleach, poured it all over that dressing room, and one of the girls took the towel from the bin, because we had a bin full of towels. So we took one towel from that bin. She just scooped it with the towel, threw it into a bag, then we double, triple, quadruple bagged it, and we put it in the trash can. But Jesus freaking Christ, send me this crappy story. Oh my gosh, it was clipped. If you could please link it in the Discord for later, I would be so happy. Okay. Jesus Christ, yeah, because I also remember when I switched jobs, I went a bit higher in the hierarchy, and I met a girl that worked in a hotel in one of really, really famous tourist cities. She worked in a 5-star hotel, and she told me that it was a regular occurrence for people to hire escorts. To hire like the most expensive to get the most expensive room in the whole hotel, so that's a few grand a night. They would hire a bunch of prostitutes, and then in the morning the whole room would be smeared with shit, and hotel staff is not allowed to discuss stuff like that, so obviously everybody knew. where to send it. We have a clip timestamp channel on the Discord. So yeah, so she told me that she was so shocked because she got a job at this really, really fancy place and shit smeared all over the fanciest apartment was a regular occurrence in there. So she told me that every time you go to a hotel, book a four-star hotel and never book the fanciest place, because that's where the obscure sex stuff happens. So that's what I do. I never go to the fanciest hotel, and I never book like really good room. You want to stick to the room that has an AC, a fridge, a bed, and that's it. And the internet maybe, because if you think like, oh, I'm going to splurge, I'm gonna get this super fancy room, the chances that somebody has shat all over the ceiling at some point, you know. You go to hotels? Yeah, sometimes I do go to work like to expos and stuff. Lately I haven't gone to an expo because of the pandemics and stuff, but before the pandemonium we would go. To work, you say? Yeah, to work to smear shit all over the ceiling. That's what I do for a living. Okay, back to the stream. Isn't the color of a shading a bit too dark? Of course, for me it looks... because it's actually very useful to work like this, because you can just kick it down like this, see? And it's really soft, right? But if you work at a higher contrast, it's just easier for you to figure out where to put it. So that's why I'm just doing it at such a dark color. So it might look a bit offensive to you right now, but once I work it out, it will be okay. No worries. I like to think that I know what I'm doing, but I'm lying. I have no idea what I'm doing. Cause I've been actually discussing shit for the past 10 minutes or so. I'm offended. Oh, just don't be. Yeah, don't be. I'm just giving you a pro tip if you ever decide to start illustrating, which is something I encourage in all my viewers, to start expressing yourself through art. It's just smart to use the digital medium to its entire potential, you know, because if you can make stuff easier for you, why wouldn't you? So yeah, please don't be offended. I'm offended, and this is Polish. I'm offended. yeah, you know, people are so easily offended nowadays that I just never know. Also, I've been told multiple times that I'm being such a bottom. I'm always apologizing to people, even if they are in the wrong. I will just end up apologizing. So yeah, that's how I roll, you know. But yeah, it does look like she dipped her fingers in Nutella now, doesn't it? And I said Nutella because we've been discussing shit for the good half of the stream. So I don't want to go back to those subjects. Is this clipped? It's not. Yeah, bad. Selection, create selection. Okay, this is good. Now this is the stuff we want to see. Yeah, that's some good shit. Shima, don't ruin Nutella for me. Oh, okay. I'm gonna fix it for you, cause I have my Toasty Mega. I think like half of my tweets nowadays are about my Toasty Mega. And if you put a thin layer of Nutella on bread, and you put in a marshmallow inside, or even if you put in a marshmallow and a cube and a square of dark chocolate and you toast it, you get those more. And it's so good. So I recommend 10 out of 10. It's really good. Ice alert. Okay. I'm gonna have some water and rest my eyes. Too poor for now to try. Yeah, if you don't have a Toasty Maker, you can alternatively make it on the pan. But the problem with making toasties on the pan is that you have to use a ton of butter. You have to use a ton of grease, or else it will burn, and the Toasty Makers, they have a non-stick surface, so it's enough to just like lightly coat it with fat. But ultimately you can even make it on a frying pan. Just put two pieces of bread, one marshmallow and one piece of chocolate inside. If it doesn't taste like coal, it's not worth eating. If it doesn't taste like coal, if it's not crunching, then why are you even eating it? Yeah, charcoal, very, very good for you. for poisoning and stuff. Helps you clean out the system from toxins. Ay. Yeah, this hand, it is like looking kinda wonky. Like I think like I should let's make it less dense, okay? Cause it should like curve here, and I feel like it's not noticeable enough that it has like a slight curve in here before those fingers, because the general shape of this hand is okay. I think it's just that I feel like I didn't capture the dimension of the object as well as I might have, as I should have, you know. Okay, maybe if we add in some highlights I will be more happy with it. The problem with illustrating late at night is that I'm never happy with my work. I'm just waiting until I get a job and move to a place with an oven. I'll have charcoal for days. Oh yeah, I had my charcoal. I had my oven fixed and I've been making a ton of pizza. My favorite recipe is Food Emperor's Detroit style pizza, but maybe without the salami, because I don't eat meat. Just with cheese, and that Detroit style pizza is really thick and the ingredients are really cheap. I had my charcoal fixed. Oh my gosh, it's 1 a.m. Please don't come at me. I did have my charcoal fixed though. Okay, so now we do the hair, and I think I will paint the apple tomorrow, maybe, because like I need to to put in highlights on the apple. But I feel like this part of the apple should be shiny, and then we should try and paint on some texture on the apple. We will see how it looks in the end. I think it's an okay illustration. Like I'm not entirely happy with it, but it's still one of the best ones I've done so far. So I am rather happy with it. Okay, this is multi ply layer for the hair. I'm gonna just go with this round flat brush, maybe. Maybe with a gray with a pinkish undertone, because ultimately we will still have to spray paint the pink onto the hair. So maybe we should start with that, actually. Hello, this is me from the other corner of the screen. I have so many ideas for oven bacon, ham, lasagna, butterscotch pie. chug. I chugged. But yeah, this is the other me that I have in there for color picking. Because I'm still not the greatest when it comes to choosing my own colors, and Shai has chosen such a delightful palette for me. But yeah, I'm not sure if I could. I'm not even sure if I could pick out a better one for myself. I probably couldn't. Shai is a delightful artist. I know that having a model that's done by a famous artist and a famous rigger really helps you. Really helps you as a VTuber in the long run, but I am just so happy to have my stuff done by people I look up to and people I can call my friends, you know? Oil paint brush, wavy oil hair. It's actually not what I wanted. Go back to this brush. Yeah, that's the brush. That's the brush I wanted. This is not the brush you were looking for. These are not the droids you were looking for. I will say Shima as many times as I want, Dad. Shima just went through mitosis. Dear God, she's starting to clone herself. Oh my gosh! Imagine if I cloned myself like how they tried to clone Kizuna Ai, and how it backfired on the channel. I'm not sure who would voice the other clones, because like I'm just sitting here doing everything on this channel. I was about to say, but yeah, that was one of the points I did on my panel yesterday, and I know that you guys were there, and I really appreciate it. But there was such a great lesson in like Kizuna's fuck up. Basically, all the corporations could learn. From what? From Kizuna's mistakes. I mean, ultimately it wasn't Kizuna's mistakes, it was company's mistake, because they thought they could bamboozle people, and people don't like to be bamboozled. Imagine if voiced one of the Shima clones. Imagine if I voiced one of the Shima clones. Yeah, just imagine, like, for next year's April Fools, we were thinking about it, just simply streaming on each other's channels with each other models, cause the song that we did this year, it caused a bit of a drama, cause we were leeching on Hololive, and how can you do that? How dare you make a meme? How dare you joke? People are not allowed to joke in 2021. So yeah, for next year we will just do something that's even tamer than recording a Rickroll song for YouTube. Instead of hearing an ara woman, they hear gay shit instead. Can I voice one too? Well, you know, like ultimately, as fun as it sounds, I think I would have to ask Shai about it, because when I commissioned the model, I got permission to use it. So I'm not sure about the clones though. Because like in the end of the day, like the illustrator still holds some rights to the illustration if they haven't like given them up officially on paper, and like we didn't because we are friends, you know. I'm scribbling. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is like if this fringe part is looking how I want it. Maybe we'll just like blur it a bit, just like just good shit. Just stretch it, just stretch it a bit to make it a bit more dimensional. I've seen so many tutorials on how to do it, and literally everybody does the hair different way. So in the end of the day, you just have to come up with your own way of doing them. We can do what Vishojo did and draw our own really shitty models. Oh yeah, like a stick figures and stuff like that. Cause rigging your own model, that's really hard, and it takes a ton of time. Takes so much time. I think that even making a s oh. So, because usually when I stream, okay, that's usually when I stream, I have my doors shut, and then there's always somebody in the living room watching if the toddler won't wake up. And now it's so late that everybody wants to go to bed, so I have to keep my door open. And make sure I'm not too loud so that I don't wake them up, you know. So okay, I just remember me. Just re not remember me. Remind me. Remind me to be really, really quiet. Because usually when I'm not streaming, I just sit in the kitchen and I'm either working. Oh, I'm drawing, and I have my door open, and nobody wakes up when I do that. So I am rather hopeful that I don't wake anybody up. Can't you just close the door? If I close the door, I won't hear if the toddler wakes up. And if they wake up, they will just get up from their bed and book it and start looking for me, because that's how little kids work, you know. They don't really think clearly when they wake up. They just book it and they just look for somebody that will take them back to bed. So it's just safer. It's just safer to have the door open. I think it's gonna be okay because it is rather late, right? So they should be deep in their sleep. Okay, so this is in the back. This back part of the hair. This to in the back. Actually, I think it's. I think this brush might be a bit too thick. This brush that I've pulled, I pulled. Maybe it should be pink in this part. Okay. The good thing about doing it all on a separate layer is that I can just spray over this layer with a spray paint tool, right? I can just take it and spray over it. Well, this part actually should be darker, so it was okay, but I can just make the corrections kinda as I go, so it's really, really neat. Spray and pray. I can hear creaking bed in the other room. I mean, it was just like a singular creak, so that means that somebody went to bed, right? Because if you hear creaking back and forth, yeah, that's no good, especially when you live with your parents and you refuse to accept the fact that adult people tend to have a nightlife too, even if they do have kids, you know. I remember when do you guys have any horror stories catching your parents in the act when you were kids? Because I honestly cannot remember catching my parents, probably because they never really liked each other that well. or maybe they were hiding. Maybe they were hiding their affection quite well from me. But I don't think I've ever caught them in the act, red-handed, you know, doing the devil's tango and stuff. Unfortunately not, shame. Luckily not, but I once found my father funky condom. Why was it funky? Like, was it flavored or what? How funky was it? I'm interested. How do you define funky for me? Okay, just like a whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. Fingertip. Select everything. Multiply. I think it's turning out how I want it to turn out. Why aren't you working? What is wrong with you? It is a bit streaky, but if we take it down a bit, I think it's actually quite okay. We'll also see if this comes together with the highlights and stuff, because now it is rather flat now, isn't it? Let's save to be safe. It was in plastic see-through box, and the tip was, I don't know. I don't know how to say it. It had thingies on the tip. Oh my gosh, that's a really, really funky one. That is indeed a funky one. What were you expecting from Shima if she saw parents getting frisky? Like, I think I caught my parents once, but it was after the fact. And they did act a bit awkward. Oh, go away, hand, I don't want you. They did act a bit awkward because they were still butt naked, and I remember they told me to leave, I think. Now that I think about it, I think they were fooling around, but at that time I didn't even connect the dots because I was just a kid, you know. But yeah, no funny stories, sadly. That was the apple. Where's the apple? That's the apple, okay. Okay, we'll just paint over the apple because I dead ass run out of fucks to give, so I'm just gonna paint over this apple. Oh, make it less dense. So apples, they tend to have stripes, right? So like a an orangey one too. Something. Maybe it was a better idea to actually do it on separate layers so that I could just like blend it more freely, because now it's starting to look kinda wet. But you gotta do what you gotta do. It does look like an apple indeed. So now the glow. I just banned a bot. Yeah, I'm rather worried what will happen if I get like raided by bots, because I know that it happens a lot, and I've seen the instructions how to deal with that. They were rather complicated, so I hope I don't get raided by bots, and if I do, I hope you guys will help me out. You guys will help me out with it, yeah. Yeah, see, because I put a highlight here and I didn't put highlights anything else, and with the highlight I think it's looking quite okay. I think it is quite okay with the highlight. No worries, just stream and I'll do my part. Thank you so much. In Blended we trust. Shima, you have emails verificated accounts only. Oh, no idea. I honestly don't know. I think I was setting up this Twitch. Let's see. Create a dashboard, community, followers list. Maybe that's it. Maybe it's any settings, moderation. Yeah. Okay. Oh, I see. Email verification. Anyone that would like to send messages in your chat room must be verified. Oh, okay. So I did check. I did tick that one. Okay, so I think that can help. I think that can help keep the bots away. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Senmi. You seem to know so much about Twitch, you know? Let's continue. Let's do the pillow now, and after the, or maybe because this skin is kind of looking lifeless, so I'm just gonna zoom hardcore onto this face. That's really creepy, right? But yeah, I did zoom in to pick the color from the illustration that Shai did, because this color palette that she chose is so beautiful. It is so beautiful, and it just it gives the character life, you know, just those small details. Just put these, oh, it's too harsh, I think, but you just put in these small details and they just bring the character to life. Just a small amount of redness, just like the smallest amounts of blood, just a tiny touch of a fleshy color. It's such a game changer, honestly. I always like to put some blush at the knee so that you guys can post your horny assumptions in the comments, but see how much better it looks with the blush. Oh, hi Mapcho, you can't sleep. Hi. Hello, nice to see you. Well, actually yeah, I did mess up my sleeping schedule today. I did mess it up because of the convention, so I'm just streaming to show my love and my appreciation to my Twitch audience. which oddly enough is like mostly my Polish viewers are here on Twitch, but I hope that I will get some more international viewers. I think that would be really, really nice to have more international viewers, but we will see. let's make it a 5. A 5 is still too much. Yeah, no, I don't like it. No, that's too dirty. Just in here, just a tiny bit. Yeah, maybe like this. Posture check. Have you hydrated, Mother Shima? Okay, I'm gonna hydrate now. Oh my gosh, my eyes still teary. Okay, and now time for a stretch. Just very, very silently, okay? And left. And right. And left. And oh, did you hear my neck crack? Jesus fucking Christ. Knuckles cracking ASMR. Oh, okay, you didn't hear that. That's good. We actually tend to hear the cracking of our bones better. because it transfers throughout our body, right? So it does transfer through our body, and we can hear it because the bones in our ear tend to tremble. That's just a fun fact with Shima for now. Pillow multiply with the pillow. Let's make it denser. Okay, let's make it stretch the cord a bit. Oh, yeah, bear. Yeah, like this. Okay. Maybe this blue is not the most fortunate choice. Maybe it should be more on the. Then I think it should like crease in here. Creases, shadows, creases. Okay, let's just shade this whole thing. Blue. Yeah, blue. Blue is actually my favorite color. I'm such a sucker for the color blue. I think that if I see something, that's really, really cute, and it's blue, it's very, very hard for me to stop myself from from buying it. Right now I'm doing my best to save money because like those of you who are my regulars, you know that I had a family member undergo surgery, and like because of the pandemics, Jesus Christ, I was on the wrong layer this whole time, but because of the pandemics we had to pay for it out of pocket, right? So I don't have that much savings left, so I'm shitting myself mentally because I'm worried if anything else goes bananas, we won't be that secured. But I'm trying to think positive thoughts. And if I work rather hard right now, if I spend more time at my day job, and if I increase my savings, I will be able to secure my finances again. So that's neat. Yeah, last year fucked up a lot of people. Yeah, you know, and the problem is that nowadays, especially if you have some health problems, if it's something that makes your life really, really uncomfortable, but it's not a life-saving procedure, you cannot do it at the hospital. So that sucks, because a lot of people end up paying out of pocket for surgeries on top of paying that health insurance in Poland, which is if you look at it, you know, internationally it's not that expensive, but if you compare it to the amount of money that people make, also this shading just looks like ass, but if you compare it to the amount of money that people make, it is really, really expensive, especially if you compare it with the quality of service that they provide. Pillow, tie. So yeah, it is. This year is rather hard for everybody, and I just hope that with vaccinations and stuff like that, things will go back to normal. We just have to, for now, nothing else than thinking positive thoughts and doing our best will save us, you know. So I'm gonna give my all and give my all everywhere and hope for the best. Color stretch a bit more. Oh no, less color stretch will be better. More. Because I want to, like, I want to like make an illusion of it like squishing. Not sure if it will look good, but. Do I like it? Yeah, let's just make it flat, really flat. Calming down at least. Yeah, that's good. That's rather good, because like I've seen especially a lot of kids being really, really affected mentally from the lockdown, spending so many times isolated from their school friends, stuff like that. And suddenly when high schools reopened, I've seen so many people on first dates and stuff, because so yeah, I can tell that people missed hanging out with their fellow people a lot, you know. Yeah, you know what's like my favorite dick move is when somebody is streaming themselves sleeping and somebody sends donation that says, "Alexa, what is my location?" I don't have an Alexa because I'm broke AF. So you don't have to send me a donation that reads, "Alexa, what is my location?" Also, I have my earphones in, so I'm prank proof, you know. Okay, how do we shade the mattress? Is what I'm thinking. So I need a gray that's pinkish in undertone. And here we go. Just like this. Maybe less paint. Like the light is from here, so it is safe to assume that it would cast a shadow on it, wouldn't it? Soft here. And honestly, right now it just looks like she died and the juices from her dead body sinking onto this mattress. It's not looking very sanitary. Well, you know, I love me a good oh, I was on the wrong layer again. But what I'm trying to say is that I love me a good art fail. Nothing better than a failed art. Isn't sleep streams against Tales of Twitch? Yeah, I think it is against Terms of Service now. Because it says that you need to be active in your streams, right? Because I remember that one streamer I used to like, he streamed overnight with AI training on and he went to sleep and in the morning he got banned. Yeah, because if you just leave it be like that, and if you have a hookup with your viewers to just like leave it on idle, then they would still roll ads even though like there is nobody. So I think that would be against Twitch, because that's not very good for them as a company. So it would make sense that they would ban practices like that, you know? Makes total sense. Like in the end of the day, they shouldn't be telling people what they can and cannot stream, but they are the generous host, so we should be following them, because ultimately the main purpose of this website is making Twitch, making Amazon a ton of money. So if there is content that's not very attractive for the people who buy ads on Twitch, they will do whatever they can to get rid of it, basically. Not to mention it's straight up dangerous for the streamers. Yeah, I did watch on YouTube some highlights from one guy's sleep and stream, and there were literally people knocking on his door. You know, and it is dangerous. So maybe it is for the better that they banned it. Maybe it is for the better that they did ban it. Oh, maybe make it softer. Yeah, let's dance. We'll go in with the soft. And make the softer. Yeah, and this one softer too. And then we kick it down. Is it good? Is it? Isn't it like to? What if I leave it like on normal? Yeah, there isn't that much difference between like normal and multiply. Blend it a tiny bit better, and then just spray it. Oh, I cannot spray it on this layer. I need to do it on this one. So yeah, because this is like further towards the back, right? Now let's add some glow and just like try to lighten this here, because we have the light source coming from here, so these parts which are more towards the font should be lighter, I think. I never gave the mattress a second thought until today. But yeah, overall I think she looks like she is laying on the bed of strawberry yogurt. I think they are banning for letting viewers interact with Alexa and Google too, because people are asking about location to call 911. Oh yeah, that's a legit concern, because you know, if people do that, like even if people were to you know get your location and order you like 200 pizzas and stuff like that, that would be a dick move, right? And if they call the police to your place and it turns out nothing is happening there, you can actually get in trouble with the law enforcement for calling the cops without the actual need for the cops. I think that is a crime universally everywhere, because you know they should be waiting for shit hitting the fan instead of like pranking Twitch streamers. So yeah, that's a legit concern. Just imagine, just imagine somebody called the police to your place or stuff like that. Or imagine if you are a streamer and you have family and somebody calls child services on you, you know, that would be scary. That would be really, really scary. Because if there is a report to child services, they have to investigate it, right? They cannot just ignore it because like they know somebody is a streamer or something. They usually have to investigate it. So you know what people are. People tend to troll. People tend to prank people, and they can actually mess up somebody's life like that. Messed up. So it all comes together to being responsible with the type of content that you put out there to the internet. So yeah, if people know your location, they can mess up with you a lot. Ice Poseidon got banned after he got swatted on the airport. I think I messed up my drawing, but just imagine being swatted. The tamest scenario. Somebody calls the child services and tells you that you beat your kids or you are taking care of your let's say you are taking care of a sick relative and your audience know that, and the trolls tell that you are like hitting your grandma or something like that, it is just so dangerous. That's why it is the safest to keep your location as private as possible. I think there is some guy in Poland that he's on YouTube and he specializes in doxing where TikTokers live, and it actually turns their life into a nightmare because TikTok is really, really popular with young kids, right? So those people, they have tons and tons and tons of kids by their door just waiting to see their idol, and that's such a dig move, you know, doing something like that just for views on YouTube. Just don't dox people, just don't do it. I'm actually running out of water. You know what? I should actually refill my water bottle. But we'll do that just in a minute, okay? Yeah, it is 2:30 now, isn't it? But I'm feeling really good working on it, so I might push it just a bit more. Also, I don't feel that sleepy, you know, so maybe I should just continue working right now. I'm just gonna do some highlights, really. And after we put in the highlights, we will try to see how this illustration looks, and if I think it is good, I will be able to move on with this project and finally record the song, send it to Pix, have it mixed, have it mastered, upload it to YouTube. I really, really enjoy, singing, and I really, really wish I could upload more songs, but it is such a labor-consuming thing to do, you know, singing, because you have to practice the song, you have to illustrate. Song, right? You need to record it like at least 5 times. You need at least 5 good takes out of like 20-30 takes. You need to have a good recording session, and yeah, then you have to mix, master, you have to upload to YouTube, make a music video. That is a ton of work for a video that's for 5 minutes. You're in the kitchen, get a glass of and pour a tap. Yeah, I do exactly that. Whenever I'm taking that break, that's like 15 seconds, I'm just going to the tap, pouring water into my cup. Because firstly, buying tap water is expensive, and secondly, not sustainable, because there is a ton of plastic waste, and thirdly, the quality of tap water is not that bad in Poland. You can pretty safely drink tap in most cities. It is safe for drinking. I mean, I know that like bottled water, it tends to taste a bit better because it has more minerals, right? But the more minerals the water has, the better taste. But it is easily fixed. You can just buy a powder online and add to your water, or you can just add a slice of lemon in there, and it will give it a very very good very very distinct taste. If you add some ice cubes, bonus points for that, you know. Okay, I'm gonna blend these a bit because I feel like this might be too harsh. Like especially on the sleeve, but overall I think it's quite all right. Or is it? I don't know. I will take a look at it in the morning. I've put a 6-pack of water bottles, but I have use for them. I usually drink tap water from the pigeon. Put a joke about the woman in the kitchen here. Yeah, I love to joke about that. you know what it's like when you are in a Polish block of flats. Usually you have like one major living area. You have like one or two tiny bedrooms, and then you have your kitchen. And my kitchen has the thickest doors. It has really really thick doors. And it's the only room in the house that's not occupied by other stuff. So I just hang out here, stream, work. I've never sat in the kitchen this long before. Whoa! Dziękuję. Thank you so much for the donation. Jesus Christ. My own donation alert is scaring me shitless. Oh my gosh. Did you guys hear that? Because I usually mess up my... Yeah, the donuts always get me. Yeah. I was told that I should change it, but I was like, nah. I don't get them that often, right? So it just adds to the comedic value of the whole of the whole thing when you have like when you have the notification go like bam. So yeah, thank you so much. Dziękuję bardzo za dyszkę. Dziękuję. Dycha, night of fever. Zobaczymy. We will see how it looks when I try to render it with Perlin noise. And yeah, we did the highlight on the kimono. Now we do the highlight on the pillow. And after the pillow... Oh, why are you not working? Okay, it will look like a satin pillow if I do it this lightly. Okay, that's good. This is good. That's the flat from the mattress. Okay. So yeah, we will just make the lighter parts lighter. So I think it will fake being a satin. So yeah, now onto the hair. The problem with having white hair is that it is so crazily difficult to shade, because like what's lighter, what's freaking lighter than light? you know, than white. Sorry, what's whiter than white? So that's the problem at Glow. So whenever I have to highlight, I'm just trying to do these parts like here and here, right? Because that's in the front, so that will be lighter, because that is lit by the non-existent light source that I added just mentally. Oh yeah, work that shit. Yeah, you gotta work that shit in, you know. Okay, but make it less paint, less dense. Yeah, that's still rather dense now, isn't it? Yeah, okay, so like this. Oh my god, that really jump scared me. Playing LOL at this hour was a bad idea. You know what? Send me. I've never actually played it, because like the amount of the toxicity that is rumored to be part of the community was rather off-putting for me. I did play a share of Dota back in my day, so maybe I could actually play it and enjoy it. I don't know, I'm still trying to figure out what kind of games I can play and stream comfortably, because you know the problem is that I tend to focus on talking and on interacting with chat more than I focus on playing the game. So usually the outcome of me playing the game is pretty bad. Donation jump scare. It isn't rumor. Oh yeah, you know, I know that some gaming communities are more toxic than others. Like the game Rust, for example, it is believed to be rather toxic, the environment of that game. I mean, also, you know what? I'm just gonna show you the picture. Okay, this is the picture, and I'm gonna move out of the way. Okay, you see it? You guys see it? I am in the way. I'm gonna move even more. You guys see it? I think that the hands that you guys don't see need some more work, but what do you guys think? I left League early in 2014 because it rotted away my self-esteem. Oh my gosh, it is that bad? Yeah, bear. I didn't think it would be that bad. Looks good. Oh, okay. Thank you, Patmos 909. Thank you so much. I think that I will go back to it in the morning and then just like dig at it some more, because I feel like this hand could use some more work. But I don't know really. Let's go merge to a new layer. Okay, in here, let's take a look at it in gray. Okay, I think this is actually shaded pretty well. Like you can clearly see which parts are lighter and which ones are darker. You know, the problem with having hair this light is that it is difficult to shade it and to and to put in highlights. Okay, I need to get some rest, slept on 2 hours since Friday. Yeah, Bess and me, go get some sleep. I'm gonna go to bed soon too. Yeah, definitely. I've been streaming for over 2 hours now. Shit. Good lord, man, get some sleep. Yeah, definitely. Send me, this is not healthy for you. Go and take some rest. Also, thank you so much for gifting me and gifting blend that sub. It means the world. But yeah, what I was trying to say is that the drawing looks overall pretty good. Looks pretty good to read. I'm especially happy with how the fabric turned out. I didn't do that many fabric studies, but it turned out quite all right. So I'm rather happy with it. So now we go filter, render, Perlin noise. And it needs to be smaller to fake the effect of to make it look like watercolor paper, basically. I don't remember what presets people used, but I think I've had a preset for Perlin. I just don't remember what it was. So I'm just gonna tweak it. I'm just gonna tweak it here and there. Okay, and now we... Oh, no, I messed up. It should be here on a new layer. Okay, now it's gonna be good. A filter, render Perlin. Okay, so let's make it simply smaller. You guys probably have no idea what I'm doing if you're not illustrators, but with this filter, you can actually fake your art being done more traditionally, because you can overlay it. Where's the overlay layer? Like this, right? And see, it looks like it was done on paper. It has this. Well, let's make it a bit more. It has this paper-like structure. It really looks like a colorful panel in a manga or something. This really, really, really tends to bring the piece together when you do it. Whoa! looks like a Death Grips music video. Yeah, it does look kind of funky, right? But I'm gonna move out of the way so that you guys can see. It does look kind of funky, but if I zoom in on the picture, you can see that it does look like that comic book paper from the 90s, or like a paper that you would use to draw on with Copics or with your watercolors. It really, really brings out the details and blends it nicely. Especially here, you can see how really, really nicely it looks. I know some people don't like it when the art looks more traditional, but I personally am a fan of digital art that looks more traditionally done, you know. So overall, I am rather happy with it. I'm not too sure about the background, if I should just leave it like this and then do some animation in the background, or if I should maybe do the background myself with like polka dots. Let's see how it looks with polka dots. With pink polka dots. And peach, maybe. I have no idea how to make a spotted texture in Clip Studio, so I'm just gonna look for it online. But maybe the composition as a whole would look a bit better. It will look a bit better without the dots in the background, actually. I'm just gonna go to Canva because it has a ton of free assets, backgrounds, which dots, polka dots. I'm just gonna try a gray one because. Paul's bizarre adventure. Yeah, you know, import image, bam. Yeah, it is so small. These dots, they are HD dots, and I'm working like 3 HD or something like that. Crazy resolution. Just really, really big one. But actually, I want to see how it will look with the Perlin noise. Wow, which one is it? Oh, it is in here. So, yeah, we marry these two. So maybe it will look better without it. Yeah, I think it looks better like this. So overall, I think the illustration is done. Maybe the hands, I could work some more on those, but overall I am pretty happy with how this turned out. I think this is objectively one of the better illustrations that I've done, and I think I'm gonna explore this style of drawing some more, you know, this style where I try to marry the Japanese animation style and the realistic proportions. I will try to draw more from life, more from videos, and then try to adapt it to make it look more to make it fit this aesthetic a bit more, because Perlin on Polka no bueno, yeah. No bueno, it just doesn't look good. And if we have the Perlin on this, it cuts away from the background, which is good because it looks more dimensional. I mean, I think it does. I'm not sure. I'm actually kind of tired, but but yeah, I think it looks better. It looks better without the Japanese animation style. You better hope the wrong person doesn't catch the wind of style. Yeah, that's why I'm not saying the words anime style. Like literally, Chestnut was the mod in my panel, right? So I said that VTubers use the aesthetic that's that's inspired by Japanese animation, because I don't want to fire up a certain person, and she was like, thank you. But yeah, I know that a lot of art teachers say that, like, oh, anime art is shit, but like anime, even freaking Disney is anime, so like, shut the fuck up. Just because something is different or something is coded or stylized doesn't mean that it's worse, you know? But yeah, you know, guys, I think we will conclude the stream right here. And you know what? I don't have anybody to raid because there isn't that many people. There isn't anybody I know streaming right now. So let's go to the suggested streamers. Let's see. Let's see who is that streaming without that many viewers. Okay, so we have Luna Mier with 13 viewers. Okay, so I think we will just write that person or rate that person. Yeah. So I'm gonna go to the creator dashboard now, and I'm gonna select her for the raid. Maybe there are Americans still left here. Yeah, you know, as I said before, I'm not very popular. Not very popular in the States, but I hope it will change. So yeah, okay, I'm starting the raid now. And yeah, I'm gonna go drink some water and go to bed. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. And yeah, I'm gonna start the raid in 3, 2, 1, good night. Did it raid? Did it work? Did it work? Hey guys, did it work? Something went wrong. Try running that quick action again raid later. There is a countdown. Oh, okay, good. So it's going to work. Okay, that's sweet. That is sweet. Okay. Chat, where is the chat? Is it counting down? Okay, so we can raid now. Mm-mm-mm-mm.